بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، respected brothers, sisters and beloved children, inshallah tonight briefly I will be sharing some reflection from just 25 ayahs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautifully explaining His principle and making us understand that whatever happening in this dunya and whatever in term of good or trial we are getting and receiving, that is result and impact of our own deed. See beautifully Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah Shura ayat number 30, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُّصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. O people, if you want to have a joyful life with the full of contentment and relax in this dunya, and you don't want to face a trial and a test and see the challenges one after the other, then just remember, engage yourself in hasanat and keep a distance from all the sayyiat. Just don't go even near to Muharramat and just spend your days and night according to those things which are permissible in Kitab Allah and had been shown through the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we'll engage during a days and night among those ahkam and farman which has been declared in Kitab Allah and shown by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be showering His mercy, His peace and blessing upon ourselves, and all the worldly affair will be taken care of. And subhanallah, there will be a ease, a joy, contentment, relax, beautiful environment, a loving and caring among the society, a community and at large throughout the whole country. Why? Because we are engaging and keeping ourselves on the right path and the right track, and we are keeping a distance from all the muharramat, the act and action which are unlawful according to laws and Allah's, the things which have been mentioned in Kitab Allah and considered unlawful, and the things have been shown and declared by the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we got to know from his ta'limat, from his guideline, that these are the things which are disliked to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and has been considered disliked to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Due to that, we are keeping a distance and making a barrier between the act and action and myself, because I don't want it to lose Allah's pleasure, and I don't want it to do anything which may become a means of Allah's anger. Then what will happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be honoring us in this dunya, making all the worldly affair very easy in a way that it will be beyond our imagination. But again, if we are not caring what are muhallalat, what are allowed and permissible, and we are not caring what are muharramat, what are unlawful, a dislike by Allah and His Prophet, and whatever coming and clicking in our mind and heart, we just want to do it, make our own worldly style, our own likes and dislikes. Who cares what Allah says in the Kitab? Who cares what has been said by Nabi Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Sunnah? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, you should know, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. When you face a trial, one after the other, when you face the challenges, when you face a difficult moment in your life, in your family, in your health, and your wealth, that one problem didn't finish, and another raise up, other didn't finish, and the third raise up, third didn't finish, and there's something else come, something else didn't finish, then something else come. If you don't want to see that, then make sure you need to give up from your own desire, your own mentality, your own plan and plot. But in fact, submit your will and your desire to Kitab Allah and Sunnah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you do that, you'll get the goodness of this dunya and the goodness of hereafter. But if you just want to enjoy this dunya, on your own way, on your own lifestyle, on your own principle, on your own mentality, and plan and plot whatever coming and click in your mind, then Allah is saying that will not happen. But in fact, what will happen? وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُوا عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. But the reality will happen that during a days and night, you will made to face a trials, a challenges, a difficulty, a various turnals of a problem, and then you will not have a solution for it. Because the solution Allah only has kept in the commands of Allah, and by following the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is saying, if you don't want to face any problem, any turmoil, any trial, any challenges, and don't want to see any difficult moment in your life, in your family, in your beloved one, in your community, then make sure engage yourself in a good amr bil ma'ruf. Do all those things what has been permissible by Kitabullah and has been allowed by the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and keep a distance from all munkarat. Each and every act and action which has been declared unlawful according to Allah's law and or according to the laws of the country, and anything has been considered disliked by Nabi Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that no matter how much worldly benefit you're seeing, how much enjoy and the contentment you may be finding, just remember, keep a distance. When you will do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this is Allah's principle in regards to this dunya, and the result of this dunya, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be booming everything for you. The door of a joy will open. Allah's mercy and blessing will be coming and covering yourself, your family, your beloved one, your community, society, and the impact of it will be found and noticed at the large entire country. But again, if you didn't care of Allah's commands, Prophet teaching, his recommendation, his lifestyle, Allah's ahkam, what has been said in the Quran, then you should know that the trial you may face, the trouble you may face, the challenges and the difficulty you may be faced, at that moment, don't curse Zayd Amr Bakr that this is happening because of that person, and this is happening because of this, and this is happening because of that. But in fact, ponder yourself and realize why this is happening. Did you follow Allah's command? Did you follow Nabi Farman? Or you was following your own lifestyle, your own desire? As a result, Allah has placed a turmoil and trial in front of you. So this is the seed you have placed, and this is the fruit you are getting because of your own amal, because of own sayyi'ah, because of own munkarat, because of engaging yourself in a khurafat, because of going against of Allah, because of denying the farman of Rasulullah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, at that moment, instead of pointing a finger towards anyone or towards someone, you rather point your finger towards your own self and towards your own deeds, towards your own a'mal, towards your own act and action, and check yourself that what you have done, how your days was, how your night was, and before it gets too late, turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you want your worldly affair ease, and hereafter also you want to enjoy. See what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in regards to those people who take care during a days and night in regards to Allah's commands, in regards to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam farmans, what he have said, what he have mentioned, what he have guided, and what he have shown us throughout all his lifestyle, that what are the likes, what are the dislikes, what are the act and action among the hasanat, that which brings Allah's pleasure, which becomes a means to get all the good of the dunya and also get the good of the akhirah, what are the munkarat, khurafat, evils, error, asayyat, which becomes a means to get Allah's anger and receive a worldly, a trial, a challenges and turnals, and what are the evil and munkarat which may become a means to achieve Allah's anger hereafter. If we will take care of it and we'll come to know it, and then we'll come to apply it and implement it in our life, and then spend our days and night each and every moment according to Allah's commands and Prophet instruction, then you know what will happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, give a glad tidings, ya Nabi Allah, to those people, those male and female, man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha. Each and every male and each and every female should know the glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will be doing amal salih, the act and action which has been proven and declared, mentioned, explained and said in the Kitab Allah, and each and every act and action has been proven by the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If any man, any woman will know that and will apply that, bring that into their life and spend their days and night accordingly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, فَلَنُحِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open for those men and women His treasure of mercy, a treasure of His blessing, treasure of His forgiveness, treasure of a joy and happiness, and Allah will make the dunya, the life of dunya, the worldly affair, ease, and He will have a joy and happiness like a joy of a paradise. My respected brothers, sisters, and beloved children, isn't we want our worldly affair to be ease, relax, contentment, tension-free, depression-free, trial-free, test-free, this-free, that-free, then there is only solution. The solution of Kitab and Sunnah. That read the Kitab Allah, understand the Kitab Allah, get to know the Ahkam Allah, and then read the Seerah of Nabi Allah, get to know who is Muhammad Rasulullah, and then, same time, share that with our family members, with our sons and daughters, with our beloved one, with our community, and at the last to the humanity, and at the same time bring that into our life, encourage others that these are the beauty, these are the quality, these are the goodness, these are the means to get the Allah's mercy and blessing in this dunya, and these are the means to achieve Allah's forgiveness hereafter. When we'll do that, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a joyful life. Yes, joyful life in this dunya, and when we'll be resurrected hereafter, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor us with His pleasure. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, forgive us. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.